I never, cried the foreman.
The workman gave him some cake. He drank three buckets of water and was just about to drink another when Henry let off steam. Cried the elephant. Water went all over Henry. Poor Henry. The elephant and his keeper were soon reunited, but Henry was most upset.
An elephant pushed me. An elephant hooshed me.
That night, he told the other engines all about it. Gordon and James felt sorry for Henry, but still teased him.
First the rain, then an elephant. Whatever will you be afraid of next?
Never mind, Henry, murmured Thomas. I think you were brave today, and really reliable, too.
I don't think so. Polka dots just aren't me somehow. I'm more the wolf dot type. Maybe this door painting wasn't such a good idea after all. Remember the unfortunate effect the new paint job had on Percy?
One morning, Percy was impatient. He was wearing a new coat of paint and longed for everyone to see it. The other engines were still dozing, but not Percy. Driver should be here by now. What's he doing?
Sleeping,
grunted Gordon. But that means I'll be late. The coaches will be waiting, and the passengers will get cross.
Rubbish,
huffed Henry.
It's still early,
added James.
You just want to show off.
No, I don't. Never mind, Percy, said Thomas. It'll soon be time for work. But be careful, or you might run into danger, and Duke is not here to save you.
Duke? Stuttered Toby. You mean our hero?
A large painting of Duke hung in the engine shed. The very same, said Thomas. Driver told me the story. Listen. And this is the story Thomas told them. Long ago, when Peter Sam was still called Stuart, and Sir Handel Falcon, he worked with Duke on his old railway, but Falcon still had a lot to learn. The manager came to see him.
Falcon, I'm pleased with your work so far. Now you must learn a difficult part of the line. We call it the mountain road.
Falcon was excited.
Yes, please, sir. So tomorrow, when you have a new coat of paint, you will go on it. Duke will explain everything. Thought Falcon. Duke's an old fusspot.
Next day came.
Listen, warned Duke. The mountain road is difficult. I'll lead.
No, replied Falcon. I'll lead. How can I learn the route with you lumbering ahead and blocking the view?
Suit yourself, said Duke. But never mind the view. Look at the track.
The engine set off.
Look at the track, puffed Duke. Never mind the view.
Fuss pot, replied Falcon. Fuddy duddy, fuddy duddy, fuddy duddy. The engine speed grew slower and slower.
Don't dawdle, urged Falcon. No hurry, no hurry, puffed Duke.
Soon they approached the tunnel. Falcon didn't like the tunnel. It was curved, and he couldn't see.
I want to get out. I want to get out, he sighed.
One moment, everything seemed safe. But then, suddenly... Falcon was derailed and hung dangerously over the edge. Duke bravely held on with all his strength.
Stop shaking, he called. I can't hold you if you shake.
Duke's driver and fireman worked quickly to make the two engines safe again. Then came more trouble.
Water, cried Duke's fireman. Duke needs water, quickly.
Luckily, there was a workman's cottage nearby. Soon everyone was passing jugs, buckets, kettles, and saucepans filled with water until Duke's thirst was quenched. All the while, Duke was building more strength. At last, with everyone's help, he was able to pull Falcon back onto the rail. Then they started off once more. The manager was waiting at the top station. He apologized for the accident.
"Your Duke," said the passenger, "is a hero. He stood firm like a bulldog and wouldn't let go."
Falcon was grateful, too. "Thank you for saving me, Duke. I don't know why you bothered after I'd been so rude."
"Oh, well," replied Duke, "you just had a new coat of paint. It would have been a pity if you'd rolled down the mountain and spoiled it."
"There, that's the perfect color. I don't know why I didn't think of it sooner. It's new and exciting, but there's something nice and familiar about it, too. It reminds me of home. In fact, I'd like to open that door and go inside and relax. Oh, paint's still wet. There must be some way. I know. Missy, turn the radio on. I'd like to see a song."